Hello, my fellow YouTubers. So today we're doing a gold and brown look, and I've already done my brown, which I'll show you what I use and everything, because I've done this video like 20 times today and can't get it right at all. So I got it right without using a being on the camera. Sorry, I gotta move my camera again. So what you did, is take a little brush, and I just made my outline with my color, which came from the Avon Sandy Corals Quad Palette. And it's this color right here, and it's a matte finish color, so it doesn't have any shimmer in it whatsoever. And I found that I like this non-shimmer with this look a lot better, because the gold has a lot of shimmer in it and this brown just tones it down a lot. So now that I have my brown on, and all I did is I made my shape and then I just filled it in. So I'm going to be using two golds from the 88 Standard Shimmer BH Cosmetics palette, and I'll be using this gold right here, and this one right here. So take your lighter gold first, which is the first color I showed you, and pat that on the part that you had no product on. And you want to do this about twice, two or three times. I do it about twice. And then take your darker color and go over that. Like so. And then once you get that on there, take your lighter gold and just go over that again, and then bring that down on your lower lash line. So I'm going to take a little bit more of the darker gold and put it over to make it even with this side. And I know that my browns aren't even, but I'm going to fix that once I get this gold finished. And I'm going to move my camera, so I apologize for the noise and the movement. Try to see if you guys can see this a little better. Right there. Oh, need to move it down just a little bit more. Like that. Right there, it'll work. Yeah, now you can see that a lot better. So I'm gonna take that same brush by e.l.f., the eyeshadow brush that I used for my gold. And I'm gonna fill in my brown a little bit. So I got my product on my brush, and now you're just gonna fill it in. And make it pretty close to the same as the other side. Like so. So now I'll take a blender or an angle brush and just blend that out. Like so. And then take another angle brush or the same one and take a white pigmented color or a creamy color. In this case, I'll be using these two, or this one, sorry, just this one, which is a white creamy color, and then I'll be using this one that is a matte as well that has no shimmer. So I'm going to take that creamy color, and I'm just going to bring that all the way around my eye, above the colors that I just made. And then I'm going to take this color, the matte white, and it's kind of a cream, I guess you could say. And I'm just going to bring that in and around the entire look. And I love Avon's makeup, especially their camo, camo. Their quad palettes, because they last forever. Girls out there that don't want to spend $30-$40 on makeup, Avon's your way to go. Just get rid of any fallout. Now, I'm going to line my waterline first. And you just want to line your waterline with a gel or a pencil or a liquid. And you don't need to make this too dark. But I'm going to go over it with my liquid liner. But I'm going to move my camera again to get in better light. And I'm so sorry about this. My liquid eyeliner, and this is Black Dress, Little Black Dress, and this, I have no idea who's by. It's made in Germany. Oh, it's an Avon product. Look at that. And it looks like this, and you want to shake it up. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Sounds like a little rattle. And it comes out like this. And I'm going to wipe any excess product that I don't want. And now you just want to go on your upper lash line. And get as close to your upper lash line as you can get. Now I generally start going back. And it's gonna look bumpy, but once I actually get it on there, it'll look neat and thin. Now, I've had a lot of girls ask me, does liquid liner hurt when you put it on your lower lash or your your waterline? No, it does not. If that is a concern that you have, it doesn't hurt at all. Now if you poke yourself in the eye, it's gonna hurt, obviously. But it doesn't hurt whatsoever. And you just wanna, when you get to the end, you just wanna bring that end down into your waterline and go across your waterline. It feels weird, yes. And you want to let it dry, and you will look like you have, like, I don't know if you can see it on mine, but I get, like, a little bit of teary-eyed when I do this because I get so close to my eye. But it, like, you know, you see that? If you get teary-eyed, it does that. And then it does that. So you just want to get a piece of toilet paper. And just fix it. Soak it up. It doesn't make a mess at all. You stick your paper towel or your toilet paper to it, and it soaks it right up. So go over that again if you want. I'm gonna go over it lightly. Blow it dry if you have to. And then just fix your upper lash line if you have any mistakes. And you're done. Now you can add false lashes or mascara. I have really sensitive eyes. I know what you're saying. She just practically poked makeup into her eyeball. But mascara makes my eyes hurt terrible. So I don't choose to wear fake lashes or mascara. So this is the finished look. I'll try to. And that is the finished look. And if you like, and please be free to try it and let me know what you think, if what you did to fix it or make it better or anything. Please leave comments and subscribe. Bye.